It's crazy. Like, we had, like, what seemed like this much in, like, probably past January's.
At Snowbasin, Mike Anderson, KSL 5 News.
Snowbasin plans to stay open on weekends as long as conditions allow. Snowbird, by the way, is the other resort maintaining a late season. They're promising to stay open at least through the 4th of July. Oof.
I think this is the first week that it really feels like summertime, finally.
It's getting there.
Yeah.
It's getting there.
And when you are in June and the days are longer, we're heading towards the summer solstice, it is going to get warmer, and there's nothing really that you can do about it. In fact, we average 54 days of 90 or above, and we're going to get there. And when it gets hot, as you look at this evening sunset, when it does get hot, it'll stay that way for the rest of the evening. Clouds, no rain this evening, but we did have one little thunder shower move through the valley and drop some rain around the University of Utah and sprinkles elsewhere. How about Island Park today? 61 and 36. American Fork, 81, 47. Manti, 79 and 46. Mesquite was 96 and a low of 66 degrees. Wow, that's not too bad. Here's your latest vortex. We have some showers and thunder showers, most of them staying away from the Wasatch Front, but they're moving across the Raft River Range and heading up into Burley and up towards the Idaho Falls area. Some of those showers and thunder showers will pop up again during the next 24 hours. And they will be in the hit and miss category. Now, to show you how much snow is still on the ground, Corey Caron was up in the cirque of the Lone Peak area. And look at all of this snow. This is 15 to 17 feet deep. This is today. It's not melting, even with the warmth in the valley. And here we are in Lone Peak looking down. Absolutely incredible vistas. If you'd like to see this photo and other photos, go to our photo gallery, KSL.com, in the weather section. Quick cast tonight, 65 and partly cloudy at midnight, starting out mostly sunny, 55, 72 by noon, and 76 at 6 p.m. Slight chance for thunderstorm tomorrow. Then on Monday, 75, partly cloudy with isolated showers and thunder showers in the afternoon and in the evening. A little higher chance, 20% tomorrow, 30% chance on Monday. I'll give you the rest of the 7 day coming up in just a minute. Bountiful, a trace of rain, 73 the high there. Elko, Samuel Lipman reports 73 and 43. Moab, one of the hot spots today, 92 degrees. Ruby Valley, Ben Neff says 71 was the high there. Salt Lake City, a trace of rain in 76. 93 in St. George and Vernal at 82 currently. 55 in Cody, 59 in Great Falls and Boise, 64 Salt Lake, still 95 in Phoenix and 64 in Los Angeles. Couple of weak weather systems. There's nothing really organized about this, but a weak upper trough sits right over this area, and these little lows just kind of move along, and one of them is pushing a few showers across far northwest Utah around the Raft River Mountains and up into southern Idaho near Elko. Here's that low. It will move towards the northeast, and then in the morning it's quiet. We'll see sunshine. During the day Sunday, notice by noon, slight chance for a thundershower, and that low kind of hangs around again. Isolated late afternoon or evening thundershowers. Monday starts out quiet, but look what happens by noon. Showers and thundershowers developing 6 p.m. through 8 p.m., so a little better chance on Monday for those showers and storms. But on your Sunday, it's going to be a great day, Moab, for getting out and doing a little outside activity. 91 for your high, a bit hot. Make sure you drink plenty of water if you're heading out, and use that SPF 30 sunscreen. 92 St. George, 80 in Manti, 82 in Nephi. The next several days, lots of sunshine. We're warming up, getting hot actually by Wednesday. Breezy south winds as a dry cool front goes by. A few clouds, but no chance for any rain. How about 7 days in the 90s? Again, we're having that slight risk for an afternoon or evening pop or drop thunder shower. Temperatures are going to stay in the mid-70s, so that's 5 cooler than usual for this time of the year. 75 on Monday and a 30% chance for an afternoon or evening thundershower, 80 on Tuesday. Wednesday into Wednesday night, Thursday, a chance for showers and thundershowers. 88 on Wednesday, by the way, with south winds, hottest day of the year.
All right.
So your flowers and your roses will start growing.
Awesome.
Finally, they're just waiting for that heat.